Hello boys and girls, so in this tutorial lessons, we are going to continue our discussions on the new outcome 3.6 cook-off rules. So in previous tutorial lessons, we learned about the resistors that we connect in series and also parallel combinations, and we find out that by reducing the circuit into a single resistance and then working backward, we can calculate the current and also the voltage drop across each of the resistor. Anyhow, class, we find out that many practical resistor network cannot be reduced to a simple series and parallel combinations like what we do in previous tutorial lessons. For example, this one. We have more than one battery and then we have many resistors sit and different path. So for this kind of resistor network that are quite complex, how we are going to calculate the current that pass through each of the resistor? So in order to compute the current in this network systematically, we need the technique that we call Kirchhoff rules that we are going to learn through this tutorial lesson. So there are two terms that we will use often in the Kirchhoff rules. First one, junction. What is a junction? A junction in a circuit is a point where three or more conductors meet. Junctions are also called nodes or branch points. For example, if we refer to this circuit network, we will find out that I label point A, B, C, D, E, F. So, point C is a junction. Why? Because we have three conductor connected here. Nampak? Ada tiga jalan yang bertemu dekat tempat ni. So this is a junction. Same go for point F. Point F is a junction sebab dia ada tiga jalan bertemu dekat titik ni. Okay? So C and F is a junction. But then A is not a junction. Same go for E. It's not a junction. B and D also is not a junction. Why? Sebab dia tak ada yang bertemu. Tapi dia adalah satu jalan yang sama. Ni adalah satu jalan yang sama. Okay? So, and then the second terms that we are going to use often is a loop. What is a loop? A loop is any closed conducting path. So, satu circuit yang tertutup, that one we call a loop. For example, C, D, E, F, back to C. That one is considered as one loop. Or we might also have B, C, F, A, back to B. That one also can consider as one loop. Or we might also have the outer loop. We can move from D, B, A, E, back to D. That one also consider a loop as long as it's a closed loop. Gelong tertutup. Okay, so this is the two terms we are going to use in Kirchhoff rules. So what is Kirchhoff rules? So we have, basically we have two Kirchhoff rules. First one, Kirchhoff first rules is referred to junction rules. So, junction rule is a statement that based on the conservation of electric charge. We know that when charge move, we produce current, right? So, according to the conservation of electric charge, there will be no charge can accumulate at a junction. So, the total charge that entering the junction per unit time must always equal to the total charge that leaving per unit time. So, charge yang masuk satu junction mesti sama dengan charge yang keluar daripada junction. Okay, so junction rule state that the summation of current that entering any junction in a circuit must equal to the summation of current that leaving that junction. So if I write it in mathematics, it means that at any junctions, the summation of current in flow in the junction must always equal to the summation of current flow out from the junction. Okay, so let's say I have this one. This is junction A, whereby I have current I1, I2, I3. This is junction B. I have current I3, I4, I5. Okay, as shown on the screen. So, how I'm going to write the equation based on the junction rules? Summation I in equal to summation I out. So, if you refer to junction A, you will find out that current I1 is flow into the junction. I2 also pointing into the junction. Okay? But I3 is moved away from the junction. So, I3 is flowing out from the junction. So, I'm going to have I1 plus I2 equal to I3. Clear? Okay, let us practice again using junction B. So, if you refer to junction B, you will find out that I3 is flow into the junction. But I4 and I5 is flowing out of the junction, out of junction B. So, I'm going to have I3 equal to I4 plus I5. Okay, so by using the junction rule, we might determine the current that flow in or flow out from the junction. For example, this one. Let's say I give you junction A. Then I know that I have current I1, 11 ampere, flowing into the junction. Then I have I2 flowing out of the junction A. I3 also flowing out from junction A. I3 is 4 ampere. So class, maybe I'm wondering, what is the value for I2? So how I'm going to calculate the value of I2? I'm going to use the junction rules. The summation of current flow into the junction must equal to the summation of current flow out of the junction. So, current yang masuk dalam junction, current that flow in the junction is I1. But the current that flow out from the junction is I2 plus I3. So, I1 is 11, I2 is unknown, I3 is 4, then I can determine the value of I2. So, the I2 will be 11 minus 4, you will get 7 ampere. Okay, so you get the idea how we are going to apply the junction rules. So, this is what we call junction rules. So, from the junction rule, we can determine the unknown current.